Hey ladies, I hope you're doing something awesome tonight on a Friday. If you're not, then I hope you're at least watching this video so you can look really awesome tomorrow. Okay, so today I'm gonna do a smoky eye tutorial using just two of the shadow scents. I'm using Sandstone Shimmer and Garnet. There are two of my favorites today. And it's gonna be really quick. I'm going to show you the brushes that I'm going to use now just so that I'm not yakking my brains out later. I'm going to use this flat brush right here. I feel like this is too small to use as a concealer brush. It's great for placing color. It's synthetic, so it doesn't grab powder well, but it's great for creamy shadows. So I'm going to use that. I think it's unique. I'm going to use this brush for my highlight. It's domed. It's a little bit dense. But it's just moves the color around real easily. So I'm going to use that to blend in my highlight. I like to use it right here too because of how round and small that is. I can get right here. And then I'm going to use a nice tapered blending brush. See how much softer this is than this? See how dense that is? See how soft this is? And I like to use this to blend in the crease area, to blend it up to the brow bone. The softer it is, the better it's going to kind of blend everything out. All right, well, let's get going. Okay, so I'm going to do my Sandstone Shimmer first. I'm going to start under the brow bone and a little bit right here. You don't want to go too much on the lid because obviously we're going to put a darker shade there. And that'll kind of take away from your smoky look. So I'm going to place that there. I'm going to blend it in. Y'all are gonna have to forgive me. I need to use like an extra mirror for this because I can't see when I'm doing it in the camera. I know I'm kind of whispering, but Miss Anna is asleep right now and she is on the couch because she's in the sick zone. And I don't want to wake her up because then she's gonna come in here and want to be in my video. Not that I mind because I love her, but I mean, mama needs a break, y'all. All right, so highlight. Look how sloppy you can do this. See, like, that is hideous. And I just, it blends right in. I like anything I can do with my fingers. And I swear to y'all, I do this with my fingers in the morning when I'm lazy. I sure didn't do a full face of eyeshadow and cheeks and everything today at the office with my finger. Not by choice. I had forgotten all my brushes, but it was perfectly fine. Okay, so. Okay, so highlight, nothing. Okay, I know I already have mascara on and all that, but it's also like 10 o'clock at night, y'all, so throw me a bone here. I did not just walk around with no makeup on for the whole day. Okay, so then I'm gonna go in with my Garnet. I love this brown. It's like, look at it. I don't know if y'all can, the lighting in here is terrible, but it's almost like a warm, rusty-ish, but not copper, if that makes any sense to you guys. Okay, so I'm gonna put this right here on my eyelid, just some dots. I like to make sound effects when I do eyeshadow, y'all. Don't judge me. Okay, and then I'm gonna blot right there. See, it's not like a lot. And if you open your eyes and it gets all up in there, it's not a big deal, because we're about to blend it out anyways. Okay, so using this brush right here, we're gonna press it in. You wanna go a little bit above the crease, just a little bit. And you can always add color. It's easier to add than to take away. So start small and build it up. And you don't wanna go too far in toward the bridge of the nose because it's gonna kind of close up your eye a little bit. And I don't want it to look, like sometimes a smoky eye can make your eyes look really small if you don't do it right. And nobody wants little bitty eyeballs, right? The whole point is to make them look more awake, bigger. All right, so my blending brush, I'm gonna go right in the crease and just kind of blend that in like a windshield wiper. And you can actually like blend it up. They're really user friendly. I mean, these things are like the training wheels of eyeshadow, but they make a really beautiful look. I mean, it's a nice color payoff. So I'm gonna build that color now. Right on the lid. And don't get all like, because just don't do that. It'll be way too hard to blend out. You'll be super frustrated. You'll end up wiping everything off and you're like, I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying here. I feel hideous today. Like, it's just too much work to try to, you know, I don't know. Like I said, it's easier to add than it is to take away. Okay, so I'm pressing it on. I'm not pressing hard. I'm not like blending it in. I'm just laying it down, right? The camera's all janky. Okay. Right in the crease. There I go with the sound effects again, y'all. Blending, blending, blending. I'm not pressing hard, really super hard with this. It just, I mean, I don't know. It kind of does its own thing. I don't, it doesn't really need my help. It just, it's shaped like your eye crease, so it just does. Okay, can y'all see that? All right. So, I'm pretty much done. It's like 6 minutes in. Okay, so I'm going to redo right here, just to make it a little bit more. Because everybody loves some good shimmer, y'all. Pretty, it's like a flesh tone, almost goldish flesh tone. I don't know. I'm terrible at describing colors, but it's so pretty. This is like my favorite one. I would use it as a base or a highlighter. It's just a nice, be like nylon from MAC or, yeah, pretty much just like that. Retrospect, I don't know. Y'all have to tell me what y'all use so I can compare it to a brand that you're familiar with. All right, so we're, yeah. Because I had washed my eyeshadow off before I did this video, like, and tried to salvage my mascara, it's like all crumbly down there. I like to touch up with concealer, or like clean it up with the concealer a little bit. I don't actually like to do a smoky eye typically with a full face of makeup on, only because the powder usually has fallout, but that's kind of the good thing about cream shadows. That's not gonna happen. All right, so I'm going back in with my Garnet. And I'm doing this so fast, y'all, because Sean is like out there awake, probably wanting to watch a movie. Oh, this brush. This is my favorite eyeliner brush. See how it's like bent? It goes exactly with the natural shape of your eye. So I'm holding it just like a pencil. So easy to just line your eyeball with. I'm just taking it right off the tip. For this particular look, because it's a smoky look, I don't want to do, I mean, this is a clean line, but I really just want it to look kind of smoky. So I'm gonna go right over top of this with that little same flat brush and just kind of blend it in very, very lightly. I'm not trying to rub it off. I'm not trying to smooth it out. I'm just trying to like make it look a little smoky, duh. Okay, you see that? First part, yeah, let me put this down. Left-handed, y'all. Who's left? All these lefties, just me. The world is not made for left-handed folks. Okay, so liner. And for a smoky eye, you really don't need to be precise. Yeah, it's actually better if you're not, because too clean of a line does not mean smoky. So I've kind of got this smudgy, pretty, smoky looking line on top. I'm sorry, y'all. Like, my eyes are watering. Hello, springtime. We missed you. All right. So here's where I'm at right now. Okay. Let's see. Where are we going now? Oh, underneath. Okay. So It's not really a smoky look. I just totally my little red right here. Okay. It's not really a smoky look if you don't go all the way around. I mean, I guess it's personal preference, but this is a smoky eye tutorial. Okay, so I'm taking that same flat brush again. Got a little bit more of that color and I'm going right up underneath. What I like about these shadows is that they dry down to a powder and they have a lot of playtime, so it's not going to just like splat on there, you know, and be permanent. Like you have, if you don't do it exactly how you want it, you have a little bit of time to adjust. So I'm going right underneath. I'm stopping at the lash line. Because I don't want, again, I don't want my eyes to look closed. I want them to look open. Let's see, just a little bit. Oh, you know what I wanted to do? I'm gonna go ahead and, this is a new color, I have Copper Rose. I am going to take a little bit on the tip of my brush and just kind of smoke this out a little bit more. This is almost like a neutral peachy color. I actually have some on my cheeks right now. I used it as a blush today because these colors are super kind of universal. You can do whatever with them. They kind of, I don't know, I have it on my lips too, actually. What is this one? Copper Rose, that's right. It's not gonna focus, nope. But yeah, I've got it on my lips, got it on my cheeks, now got it under my eyes. I want this to be a tiny, tiny bit darker, so I'm going to grab a little bit more. I actually grabbed it too much, so if you do that, see how big that is? That's too much. If you do that, I'm going to grab it with my brush, I'm going to move it right on over here. Just pressing it down. Blending brush. Just pressing. Now this step is not necessary. Typically I would have done this before the eyeliner part, but when I looked in the big mirror I noticed I wanted it to be a little bit more smoky. You know what's bad is that the faces that you make whenever you're doing makeup are so embarrassing, and I'm doing them on a video for a bunch of my friends and family. That is sad and ghetto. But now everyone knows you're not in the boat alone. We're all together. All right. And now we're done. This is a little bit smokier than I had earlier. So it's kind of fun. Let me just touch up. See, this is why my videos get long now, because I go all like, let me just do this real fast. Why don't I try this? I'm going to take a little bit more of this Copper Rose, and I'm going to touch up this blush because now that my eyes are darker, I just want it to be a little bit darker. I'm just grabbing it. I have to say, like, I'm really feeling using creams now instead of the powdery stuff because this stuff lasts and it doesn't get cakey. I mean, it's a cream. Okay, so here is the final look, the unveiling. If you feel like you need more concealer, like I always need more concealer because I look sleepy. You can touch that area up. I'm just gonna use my foundation brush because there's probably foundation on it somewhere. Okay. Let's see. Can you see me?